Mrs. N. Vijaya, working as Associate Professor in the Department of Electronics and Communication Engineering at College of Engineering Guindy, Anna University, Chennai. Her area of research includes analog VLSI and electronic circuit design. She has 30 years of teaching experience. She received CDIL Award for Best Paper 1998 from the Institution of Electronics and Telecommunication Engineers.
Welcome to UGC Lectures on Practical Session. Today we are going to see about inverting and non-inverting amplifier, how to design an inverting and non-inverting amplifier using operational amplifier. So, for this we must know what is the theory behind operational amplifier, what does operational amplifier consist of, and what are the ideal characteristics of op amp, and what are the golden rules of operational amplifier, and apply those rules to determine the gain, and then we have to design for a given gain. So, we will just go into this. So, the aim of the experiment is to design an inverting and non-inverting amplifier for a given gain. The components that is required is a dual power supply, that is a power supply for the op amp, you have two supplies, plus 15 and minus 15, then resistors, CRO, function generator and multimeter for measurement. So, an operational amplifier, the model of the operational amplifier is shown in the figure here. If you see here, you have two inputs V1 and V2. This is known as the V1 is known as the inverting terminal, and V2 is known as the non-inverting terminal, and the input resistance of the operational amplifier is denoted as R1, and A is the open loop gain here, and Vd is the difference voltage between V1 and V2. R0 is the output resistance of the differential amplifier. For an ideal amplifier for 741 op amp, if you see, Ri is around 1 mega ohms and R0 is around 50 ohms, and A is 1 lakh, approximately 1 lakh. So, if you see, the open loop gain is approaching infinity, and the ideal, for an ideal op amp, if you see, Ri is infinity, A is infinity, and R0 is output resistance is 0. So, based on this ideal concepts, we have to see what are the rules that we have to apply for the operational amplifier. In an operational amplifier, if you apply any input in the open loop configuration, any voltage in the order of nanovolts or less than that also, the output is going to be infinite, because any voltage that is multiplied by the open loop gain, which is infinity, the output is also going to be infinity, but that infinity will be seen in your CRO as plus 15 or minus 15, that is the supply voltage. So, the maximum voltage that will be shown on the output is going to be plus 15 on minus 15 for an open loop configuration. So, we cannot use operational amplifier in the open loop configuration for amplifier purpose. What does an amplifier mean is, whatever input we give, it has to produce an output which is linearly proportional to your input signal. For example, if you give a sine wave of 1 kilohertz, the output is going to be amplified, the amplitude of the signal is going to be amplified by the given gain, and the frequency will remain the same, and the phase also will remain the same depending upon the input where you are going to give. If you give it to the inverting input, means the signal will get inverted at the output. If you give the signal at the non-inverting terminal, that is V2 here, the signal will be in phase. So, we will see the pin configuration of 741 op amp. So, if you see here, pin number 1 is the offset null. If you have any offset current or offset voltage, we can connect a resistance, compensating resistance here from 1 to ground. Pin number 2 is the negative terminal or the inverting terminal. Pin number 3 is positive terminal or non-inverting input. Pin number 4 is negative supply, which will be connected to minus 15 of your power supply. And pin number 5 is again an offset null for making the output 0 if you have any offset current or offset voltage. Pin number 6 is your output voltage, and 7 is connected to positive supply, which is plus 15. 8 is no connection. This is your pin configuration of 741. So, this is the internal structure of 741, which is manufactured by National Semiconductor. So, if you see here Q1, Q2, Q1 here is the non-inverting input, Q2 is going to be the inverting input signal. This Q1, Q3 forms a cascode amplifier, Q2, Q4 forms another cascode, and they form a differential amplifier, and this is biased by Q6. And if you go further down, this Q5 and Q6 forms the active load for the cascode amplifier. So, active load will give you an output resistance which is high. So, if you see the gain of the op amp here, differential amplifier, it is going to be GM into R0. So, GM is the short circuit transconductance of the differential amplifier here, and as it is a cascode amplifier, it is going to be GM1 into the output resistance of the cascode. The output resistance of the cascode is going to be, so the gain of the cascode differential amplifier, it is going to be GM 4 into R0 4. So, it is GM squared R0 4, that is the gain given by the cascode amplifier. That this is going to be including the active load here, if you take the gain is going to be GM 1, GM 4, R0 4 parallel with R0 6. So, if you see the gain of the first stage of the operational amplifier in open loop configuration, it is going to be GM 4 R0 4 parallel R0 6. So, this is the gain of the first stage. Now, when you come to the second stage here, here you have a Q15 which serves as a level translator, and Q17 is the next gain stage. So, if you see here, this output is given here to Q15. Which is a level translator. Why we take a level translator is, this output will have a shift in the DC. So, that has to be cancelled, and we make use of Q15 as a level translator, and this is given to the, it is an emitter follower, Q15 is an emitter follower. The output is taken at the emitter terminal and given to Q17, which operates in common emitter configuration, and the output is given to the output circuit power stage. So, this is a brief explanation of the operational amplifier, what is inside this. Based on this input differential stage only, we get the characteristics of the op amp. That is, it has dual input. If you take the input resistance of the operational amplifier, it is going to be very, very high. So, when the input resistance is very high, the current which is entering into the inverting and the non-inverting terminals will be 0, because of the, you have an open circuit, it is R I is infinity, means it is an open circuit. So, that is the, and due to the open loop gain of the operational amplifier is very, very high. So, what does it imply is, A is equal to V 0 by V I. So, if this is equal to infinity or a very large value, means this V I has to be very small, tending towards 0. So, what does this V I equal to? This V I is equal to the difference V 1 difference V 2. So, when this will become 0 is, when the two terminal voltages V 1 and V 2, they become equal. So, when they become equal, when V 1 equal to V 2, V D is equal to 0, the difference between these two voltages becomes 0. So, the gain, if you see, it is V 0 divided by V I, which is V I, which is equal to V D. So, this voltage when it becomes equal to 0, your gain becomes infinity. So, when the gain of the op amp is infinity, it implies that these two terminal voltages must be equal. So, these are the rules that we have to apply for the analysis of the operational, any circuit which is involved with operational amplifier, we have to adopt the two rules. What are the two rules is, if the input as the input resistance of the different operational amplifier is infinity, the current entering the two terminals must be 0. Then, because the open loop gain of the operational amplifier is infinity, the two voltages V 1 and V 2, they should be equal. That will tend to Vd equal to 0. So, these are the two rules which we have to remember for any analysis of the circuits using operational amplifier. So, an ideal op amp, if you take, if you see here, these are the two currents which are entering the positive terminal in non-inverting terminal and inverting terminal, which is operated in the open loop configuration. Open loop means there is no feedback from the output back to the input. But this op amp is a non-linear. Any output which is going to, which you are going to get for any input given in the open loop configuration will be a non-linear operation. Non-linear operation means the output is not proportional to your input signal. First one is V 0 is equal to A V into positive input, the difference between the two voltages, positive and negative voltages. The open loop gain is very large, approaching infinity, and the two currents must be equal to 0. As we saw before, these are the two rules that we have to apply for the analysis of the op amp. Now, here if you see, these are the two voltages V I. If you say V I means V I is equal to V 1 minus V 2. This is V 2 which is applied at the positive terminal, V 1 is the voltage applied to the negative terminal. So, V I is equal to V I or V D. V I have mentioned it as V I. V I equal to V D, V 1 minus V 2. This is going to be the output voltage. So, we saw here I 1 equal to I 2 equal to 0 due to infinite input resistance, and V I is negligibly small or approximately V I is approximately equal to 0 volts. The operational amplifier, if you see again same thing, infinite open loop gain, 0 output resistance and infinite input resistance, these are ideal cases. But practically, if you see, A is will be in the approximately equal to 1 lakh. R 0 is equal to 50 ohms, R I equal to 1 mega ohms, that is 1 into 10 power 6 ohms. So, when we see that any signal which is given, that is going to be multiplied by 1 lakh, and then that will be the output. So, any signal multiplied by the gain of the amplifier will give you the output signal. So, it is going to, whatever may be the signal which is in the order of nano volts also, it is going to exceed, for example, 10 power minus 9, if it is going to be multiplied by 1 into 10 power 5, if you take, it is again going to be 10 power minus something. So, if you have a negative voltage at the output, that will go to negative saturation, any positive output will go to the positive saturation. So, this will give you a non-linear output if you operate the op amp in the open loop configuration, that is previously in the open loop configuration. This is the open loop configuration. If you operate this in the open loop configuration, you are going to get a plus 15 or minus 15 depending on these two inputs. If the input to the negative terminal is larger than the input given to the positive terminal, this will go to negative saturation, that is minus 15. If the input given to the non-inverting terminal is greater than the input applied to the inverting terminal, output will go to negative saturation, that is minus 15. So, minus 15 you will get when V 1 is greater than V 2, you will get plus 15 when V 2 is greater than V 1. This is open loop configuration. So, to get a finite output, we have to provide negative feedback to the operational amplifier. So, that is the feedback network. The feedback network is going to be a resistive network. So, once you apply feedback, the output will attain a finite value, which will be multiplication of the gain. So, the golden rules of the op amp is the output attempts to do whatever is necessary to make the voltage difference between the two terminals be 0 and the input current draws no current. So, now we will go to the inverting amplifier. So, when you see here the inverting amplifier, here we are giving the input to the inverting terminal, that is pin number 2. This is non-inverting terminal, is pin number 3, and this is 6. This is the output terminal of the IC version. So, So we are going to do the experiment on the using the 741 IC, which is a 8-pin IC. So we are going to give a connect a resistance here and do this. How to perform this analysis of this, how to determine the gain of the inverting amplifier is, this point is ground, this point is ground. So pin number, that is V3, is equal to 0 volts. If you apply the rule of the operational amplifier, V3 should be equal to V2, that is V plus is equal to V minus, that is voltage applied to the non-inverting is equal to the voltage applied at the inverting terminal. So if you apply the Kirchhoff's current law, if you see here, current I1 is equal to Vi minus 0, this voltage is 0, so here also I will get 0 volts. So Vi, the potential difference is Vi minus 0 divided by R1, that is the current, and no current can enter into the op amp because Ri is infinity, no current will enter, so the current has to enter through R2. So what is the current that is going to enter through this is 0 minus V0, so here it will be 0 minus V0. So here if you write this current I1 is equal to Vi by R1, that is equal to the same current through this is equal to 0 minus V0 divided by R2. So if you solve this for V0 by Vi, this is equal to minus R2 by R1. This is going to be the gain of the inverting amplifier. So the gain of the inverting amplifier is equal to minus R2 by R1. So if I give Vi equal to 1 volt, R1 is equal to 1 kilo ohms, R2 equal to 10 k. So what will be the output is equal to minus, because negative input, we are given the input to the inverting terminal. So minus 10 k by 1 k, which is equal to minus 10. So if I give an input of 1 millivolts, what will be the output? Output will be 10 millivolts, that is all, output will be 10 millivolts. Suppose if I give Vi is equal to 2 volts, V0 will now become, it will be equal to 2 into 10 minus 20 volts. This minus 20 volts exceeds minus 15 volts. So the output will not show minus 20, instead it will show minus 15. So what does it mean is, we can apply a range of input voltages for which the output is less than minus 15. Or if you give negative voltage, suppose if you give minus 10 volts at the Vi, V0 will now become equal to what? V0 will become equal to plus, minus minus plus. So minus minus plus, it will become equal to minus 20 volts it will be. So when the input is equal to minus 10, V0 will be equal to, V0 is equal to minus 10 into minus, gain is minus 10. So it will be 100 volts. 100 volts is not possible when you have a supply of only plus or minus 15 volts. So output cannot exceed plus 15 or minus 15. So we have to see to that the input voltage should be so given such that when it is multiplied by the open gain of the operational amplifier, which is minus R2 by R1. When the input signal is multiplied by Vi, this should not exceed plus or minus 15 volts. If it exceeds plus or minus 15 volts, means it will be retained at plus 15 or minus 15 only. So non-inverting amplifier, if you see, the input is given at the positive terminal, that is pin number 3, this is, and pin number 2 is the inverting terminal. What is going to be the gain of this operation non-inverting amplifier? We will see what is the voltage at V2. What is the voltage at V2 is V0 into it's a potential divider. R1 and R2 is a potential divider. So, V2 is equal to whatever is the voltage here, that is going to be, no current will enter into this terminal. So, same current will flow through the series resistance R1 and R2. So, you will have the current is V0 divided by R1 plus R2 multiplied by this resistance will give you the voltage at the pin number 2. This voltage is equal to Vi, the non-inverting voltage here. So, we will see what is Vi. The closed loop voltage gain is AF is V0 by Vi. Vi is equal to V plus, that is equal to V minus, that is equal to V0 R1 by R2. So, that will give you a feedback gain of, that is the overall gain of the operational amplifier is V0 by Vi, which is equal to 1 plus R2 by R1 plus R2. As before I told, the voltage V0, which is equal to Vi into 1 plus R2 by R1 plus R2, this is equal to, this should not exceed plus or minus 15. In the positive direction, it should not exceed plus 15. In the negative direction, it should not exceed minus 15. So, accordingly, you have to supply the input voltage. That we will see in the lab. If it exceeds, what is going to be the output? That we will see in the lab's practical session. When you construct the circuit, we will see how it is going to vary. So, this is the gain of the non-inverting amplifier. An exercise, if you see, this is a what type of amplifier it is, how to identify this amplifier, whether it is an inverting amplifier or a non-inverting amplifier is, you have to see where the input is given to the amplifier. The input is given to the negative terminal. So, it is what? It is going to be an inverting amplifier. So, what we expect at the output is, the gain of the operational amplifier, inverting operational amplifier is, as we saw before, it is going to be minus R2 divided by R1, that is equal to minus 150 by 12k, 150k divided by 12k, it is minus 12.5. How to verify this result practically is, we can apply some voltage. Say for example, we can apply 0.500 millivolts you apply here, that if it is multiplied with 12.5, that should be available at V0. So, if you give a DC signal, we can measure the output using multimeter. If you give an AC signal, you can see the output in the using a CRO. So, any AC signal, we can use function generator and give the signal. Now, what is the application of the inverting and non-inverting amplifier is, we can use to sum many voltages. So, a sum of voltages can be amplified using a inverting amplifier. This is inverting amplifier as the input is given to minus. So, V1 plus V2 plus V3 is going to be added at this point and multiplied by the gain of the operational amplifier to get V0. If you see here, no current will enter into this. So, what is the total current at this particular node, which is known as virtual ground? I will tell you what is meant by virtual ground later. Now, here we see I1 plus I2 plus I3 minus I4, it is equal to I4 actually, I1 plus I2, I1 plus I2 plus I3 is equal to I4, because no current enters, this total current here will just go through the RF. So, if you simplify this, what is I1 is V1 divided by R1, VI1 divided by R1 is I1. I2 is VI2 by R2 and so on. So, this will be equal to this current, what is I4? I4 is equal to 0 minus V0 divided by RF. So, if you equate this and simplify, you will be getting this equation. So, your output voltage is going to be minus RF times the RF, it is going to be proportional to the sum of the input voltage. Output voltage is going to be proportional to the input of the sum of the voltages applied. So, what is meant by virtual ground is, by the rule of the op amp, we saw that the two inputs must be equal. The input applied to inverting and non-inverting, they should be equal because the input resistance is infinity. So, when this positive input is grounded, this point has to be maintained at 0. So, what is the difference between ordinary ground and virtual ground is, the ordinary ground is actually connected to 0 potential. It is connected to 0 potential and it is having 0 volts, whereas the virtual ground is not physically connected to the earth point or the 0 potential, but it is maintained at 0 potential by means of some circuit. That circuit is only the operational amplifier operating in the inverting mode. This point is maintained at 0 potential by connection, but this point is also maintained at 0, but not by physical connection. That is going to be the difference between the virtual ground and the ordinary earth point. So, this virtual ground concept will come in the inverting amplifiers. Here this is a sum by which we can find out what is the output. This amplifier, if you see, what is the input is given at the negative terminal. So, the gain of this amplifier is minus 500 k divided by 50 k, which is an inverting amplifier. So, if I give here 0.5 means 0.5 into 2, that will give you 1 volt. So, I will get 1 volt here, that is 1 volt, and this is going to be say another 1 volt. If you take, what is going to be, this is the inverting summer, it is an inverting summer. So, you will get a output voltage which is going to be proportional to these two voltages. This you can do the construct the circuit and see what is going to be the required output. So, this is a exercise that you can do here. Here calculate the input voltage if the final output is equal to 10.08. We have to go from the backward. So, here it is non-inverting amplifier, because the input is given at positive input. Next is going to be an inverting, the output here is given back to the inverting terminal, and next is going to be inverting again here. So, if the output is 10.08, what is the input voltage? So, we have to work from backward. You see V 0 is equal to, in terms of V B, what is going to be V 0 is, V 0 is equal to minus 100 k divided by 5 k into V B. From that you find out what is V B. Next, we can find out V A if we know what is the gain of the stage. This is an inverting stage. So, gain is equal to 1, 5 k divided minus 1. So, 5 k divided by 5 k, it is minus 1. So, this from the output I can get what is V A, which is 0.50, just an inversion, that is all. Next is going to be inverting amplifier, the if the output is 0.504, what is going to be the input signal? This is a non-inverting amplifier. So, V A is equal to 1 plus R F by R 1 or R 2 by R 1 into V 1, this voltage, it is going to be 0.168 volts. So, this we can verify in the lab. So, next we will see how to connect this circuit practically and get the result. The equipments that are required is oscilloscope, function generator and dual power supply plus or minus 15 volts and 741 IC and also resistors for the circuit diagram. So, if you see the power supply, you have plus 15 with respect to ground and minus 15 with respect to ground. This plus 15 goes to pin number 7 and minus 15 goes to pin number 4, and this common point goes to the circuit ground, that is the power supply connection. So, from the function generator, we give a sinusoidal signal that is taken from this point and it is given to pin number 2 through the resistance R 1. And in this function generator, we can choose any type of signal that we need. Here I have chosen a sinusoidal signal to be amplified. Here we see the inverting amplifier, pin number 2, the we see here is the inverting terminal, pin number 2 to 6, we connect the resistance RF, and pin number 2 to the input signal, this resistance is going to be the R 1. So, gain of the amplifier is minus RF by R 1. And this goes to the input signal from the function generator. So, the function generator is giving you a sinusoidal signal of voltage say 100 millivolts, peak to peak amplitude is 100 millivolts, that is given as the input signal, And what we expect at the output is 10 times the input signal and also inverted in the nature. So if you see the CRO, the second one, the bottom one will give you the result output signal, which is inverted with respect to the input signal out of phase. This signal is the input signal, sinusoidal signal, which is given to the inverting terminal through the resistance R1, whose peak to peak amplitude is 100 millivolts. So the output what we expect is 10 times this 100 millivolts, which is equal to 1 volt. So this signal is going to be 1 volt signal, and if you see the phase, they are opposite. See, the negative peak is coinciding with the positive peak. So the output is getting inverted with respect to the input signal and also amplified. So this is the result of the inverting amplifier for any AC signal. This can also be done for any DC signal. The maximum output that you can get is only plus 15, which is the positive saturation. Negative, you can go up to minus 15. So maximum peak to peak that you can get is plus or minus, plus that is 30 volts, plus 15 on the positive and minus 15 on the negative. So peak to peak maximum you can have only 30 volts. Beyond that, it will be, you will not get a sinusoidal waveform, you will get a clipped waveform. Non-inverting amplifier, here we are going to use operational amplifier in the non-inverting mode. That is, the input signal is given to the pin number 3, which is the non-inverting terminal, and the output is taken at the pin number 6. Then as the inverting amplifier, we are connecting an RF resistance between pin number 2 and pin number 6 equal to 100K. Then from pin number 2 to ground, I connect the resistance R1, which is equal to 10. So the gain of the amplifier, as we have seen before, it is equal to 1 plus RF by R1. We are going to get a gain of 10 plus 1, that is 11. So the gain is 1 plus 10, 100K divided by 10K, that is equal to 11. The gain required is 11, and the input is given to the pin number 3, which is non-inverting input. So the difference between the inverting and the non-inverting amplifier is, the gain is going to be 11, and also the phase reversal, there will not be any phase reversal here. The output is going to be in phase with the input signal. You see the display of this. That is, this is going to be the input signal whose peak to peak value is equal to 100 millivolts, and the gain of the output signal is going to be 11 times the input signal. That is, 100 millivolts into 11 is 1.1 volt we have to get. So this signal is going to be in phase with the output signal. Here what we see is the signal, the output signal and the input signal are in phase, and the output signal is the amplified version of the input signal. Thank you.